Hey guys, you are now watching part 2 of my OS X Lion hidden features, some features you may have not heard of. If you want to watch the first video, just click this video right over here. It'll take you right to it, and then you can come back to this video. Otherwise, let's take a look at some new features. So the first feature I want to share with you all is called full screen sharing. This was originally found on Snow Leopard, but now you have a few more advanced controls. So basically what it is you can see the screen from your MacBook Air or your MacBook Pro, and then you can display it on your iMac or vice versa. And let me just give you a little demo of it real quick, and then afterwards I'll show you how to set it up. So basically anything you do on your MacBook Air, it will be displayed on your iMac. There is a little lag, that I guess it's depending on your Wi-Fi connection, but it's alright. It's not mainly for watching videos or anything like that, just doing simple tasks like writing a document or just viewing some pictures. I'll show you a quick clip of a video. Let's see if you guys can see if there's any lag. So as you can see, there's a small lag. It might bother you, it might not. It's not mainly for watching videos, mainly for just like tasks such as writing a document, browsing the web, going through email. So for just simple tasks. So let me show you how to set this up. It's real simple. So first, you're going to go into System Preferences, click on Sharing, and then check the box Screen Sharing. And now the trick is you also have to do the same exact thing for the computer you want to share the screen with. So earlier I was sharing the screen with my MacBook Air, so go ahead and repeat the same process on your MacBook Air. Once you have done that, you're going to go to the Finder, click under Shared, find that MacBook Air, click it, and then click on Share Screen. It's going to ask you to type in that password of the MacBook Air, and then hit Connect. And then right in front of you here is a screen of the MacBook Air, and you can take it to full screen. And as I told you earlier, there are some more advanced controls. You can find them up on the top, and you can fool around with those yourself. And it might improve the lag, it might not. It could come in handy for a few people, and it might just be better than buying a cinema display that costs about $1,000. The next feature is in the Mail application. When you have a conversation with someone, you're sending emails back and forth, and there's multiple emails with multiple threads, and you're not sure which message is from who. Now with conversations, it clearly separates out each individual message. So let me show you real quick. To set it up, just select a message and then click on View in Mail, and then click on Organize by Conversation. And now when you click that message, it clearly shows each individual message from each person, and it's just an easier way of looking at your messages. In the last video, I showed you how to control your music during a screensaver. Well, right now, I'm going to show you how to control your pictures during a screensaver. So what you're going to do is select one of your photo albums for a screensaver. And then, when the screensaver is playing, you can control the pictures and you can flick through them by hitting the arrow keys. So the right arrow keys will advance the pictures. And then if you hit the left arrow keys, it'll take you back. And if there's a picture that you want to pause, just hit the top or bottom arrow key and it will pause the slideshow. And if you want to resume, just hit the top or bottom arrow key once again, and then you're back to your slideshow. So it's a nice feature to know about, and it's just as cool as the jukebox I showed you in the previous video. Before we go, I just want to show you some quick mission control tips. On the top, you have four desktop screens, four desktop spaces. If you want a new space, just move your mouse cursor to the right top corner of the screen, click the plus button, and now you can drag stuff into that new space. And now, if you want an application to only open in this space only, what you can do is you can go to the dock, find that application, right click it, go to options, and then assign to this desktop. So whenever you open calendar now, let's say I go to a different space, whenever you open the calendar, it's going to open in that space that you assigned it to. And one thing I'm not sure if you guys knew about yet is you can have a custom desktop wallpaper in each of your individual spaces. So if I click one, I can right click, change desktop wallpaper, and select a new wallpaper. And now if I go back to Mission Control, it changed the wallpaper, and you can have a custom wallpaper in each individual space by just right-clicking on the screen. One of the most frequent questions I get is, where do I get my wallpapers? Well, I get them from a site called imacwallpapers.com, pretty simple site, and they have all these great high-definition wallpapers for your Mac, your MacBook Air. So basically what you do is you just click on one, and then it gives you all these options. Which device do you want to download it to? Your iPad, your iPhone, your iMac, different size screens. Basically, you just select one and you can download it right to your computer. So this is the site where I get all my wallpapers for my Mac, and they have some really nice high definition wallpapers. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Wait, Brandon, hold on. Hey guys, do you like seeing these Mac tips and tricks? If so, I'll make more. Just tell me in the comments below. All right, if you like my content, please subscribe right over here. And I'm also holding a giveaway with my buddy Christian from King Atlas 89. We're giving away some awesome prizes, at least 7 prizes or more, I forgot. All you have to do is tell us what you do with your Apple stickers. And to go to that video and to get some more information, just click that video right over here and it'll take you right to it. So, thanks for watching and I'll see you all next time. Take care.